Hey there, welcome back to Accounting Stuff. I'm James, and in this video, you'll find out how to calculate depreciation using the sum of the year's digits method. So let's get cracking. Depreciation is the process of reducing the book value of a tangible fixed asset due to use, wear and tear, the passing of time, or obsolescence. Sum of the year's digits depreciation is an accelerated variable cost depreciation method, where the expense is higher in early years. If you saw my double declining balance video last week, you might notice that this description hasn't changed. That's because both of these are accelerated variable cost depreciation methods, but the calculation behind each one is different, as you'll soon see. Time for an example. You know that big empty field you own? The one behind your house that catches all the sun? Anyways, one day you decide to turn it into a solar farm. A solar panel is a tangible fixed asset. It's tangible because you can touch it, and it's fixed because you plan to use it for a long time. Each panel cost you $25,000 and is expected to last for 5 years. By the way, did I mention that you're also really, really rich? After that, their value will drop right down to $5,000. Let's depreciate one of these panels using the sum of the year's digits method. Step one, write down what you know. Your asset is a solar panel, and we'll depreciate it using the sum of the year's digits method. Asset cost is what you initially paid for it, $25,000. Its residual value at the end of its useful life is $5,000, and its useful life is 5 years. We'll leave depreciation rate and depreciable cost blank for now because we'll work these out in step three. But first, step two, build a depreciation schedule. The depreciation schedule is a table, and for the sum of the year's digits method, it has 6 columns, so that's one more than we used for the straight line and double declining balance methods. We have year, opening book value, depreciation rate, depreciation expense, accumulated depreciation, and closing book value. Can you guess which one's new? It's depreciation rate. We're going to give depreciation rate its own column because this is going to change each year. Step three, calculate the depreciation rate, depreciation expense, accumulated depreciation, and book values for each period. Time to fill this sucker out. We'll begin with the first accounting period, so that's year one. Your opening book value is the carrying amount of your solar panel at the start of the year. This is your first accounting period, so that's going to match your asset cost of $25,000. Now let's work out your sum of the year's digits depreciation rate for year one. By the way, we often shorten sum of the year's digits to just SYD. It's just quicker to say, I guess. Your SYD depreciation rate is equal to the remaining useful life of your asset divided by the sum of the year's digits. Your remaining useful life is exactly what it sounds like. How many useful years you have left on your solar panel. We said at the start that it has a useful life of 5 years. So in year one, its remaining useful life is also 5 years. But be careful because this top line changes each period. Now the bottom line is called the sum of the year's digits and it doesn't change. We only have to work it out once. There are two ways to do that and I'll show you both. The long way is more intuitive. We're after the sum of the year's digits, so all we need to do is add up each year of your solar panel's 5-year useful life, so 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, which is 15 years. Seriously, that's all there is to it. Now for the short way. Mathematicians call a series like this the sum of an arithmetic series, and they've derived a short formula that'll give us the answer every time. Sum of the year's digits is equal to useful life multiplied by useful life plus 1 divided by 2. So let's test it out. 5 years multiplied by 6 years divided by 2 gives us 15 years. I have included this in my depreciation cheat sheet, so if you'd like to support this channel and keep a handy little reminder of the formula, then you can buy a copy of it on my website. I'll link to it down in the description. Choose your method, it doesn't matter which, and let's move on. Your depreciation rate for year one is 5 years, which changes each year, divided by 15 years, which remains the same. This gives us 1/3, or 33.33%. Now let's calculate your depreciation expense. This is your SYD depreciation rate multiplied by your depreciable cost. It represents the amount of your solar panel that you'll write off as an expense to your income statement during the year. Keep in mind that the sum of the year's digits method is an accelerated variable cost depreciation method, where the depreciation expense is higher in early years. We'll come back to this graph in a moment. We've already worked out your depreciation rate for year one. It's 33.33%. Your depreciable cost is the difference between your asset cost and residual value. $25,000 minus $5,000, which is $20,000. This is the chunk of your solar panel's book value that will depreciate over its useful life. One third of $20,000 is $6,667, your solar panel's depreciation expense in year one. Accumulated depreciation is the sum of all depreciation expenses incurred to date. In year one, it's the same as your depreciation expense. Closing book value is the carrying amount of your solar panel at the end of the year. This is the net asset amount that you're holding in your balance sheet. We can work it out by taking your opening book value of $25,000 minus your depreciation expense of $6,667, which is $18,333. Now we'll repeat the process for the following period. Your closing book value in year one becomes your opening book value in year two. Your depreciation rate is the remaining useful life of your asset divided by the sum of the year's digits. This is year two, so your remaining useful life has reduced to 4 years. Sum of the year's digits doesn't change, it's still 15 years. So 4 years divided by 15 years gives you an SYD depreciation rate of 26.67%. Your depreciation expense is your SYD depreciation rate multiplied by your depreciable cost. So that's 26.67% multiplied by $20,000, which is $5,333. Accumulated depreciation is $12,000 and your closing book value is $18,333 minus $5,333, which is $13,000. Here's the completed depreciation schedule for the whole of your solar panel's useful life. Your asset cost at the start is $25,000 and we've written off a depreciation expense to your income statement each year. After 5 years, the closing book value of your solar panel has decreased to $5,000, which is exactly the same as the residual value that we picked at the start. This is just a handy little check to make sure that we've done things right. Let's have another look at all of this on the graph. This is your solar panel's book value over time. Your asset cost at the beginning is $25,000 and its residual value at the end is $5,000. Your depreciable cost is the difference between the two. The solar panel has a useful life of 5 years and its remaining useful life decreases over time. The depreciation expense is variable because it changes each year and it's accelerated because it's higher in early years. But not all variable depreciation methods are accelerated, as you'll see in the next video where I'll cover the units of production method. Make sure you subscribe if you'd like to watch that. You can find all of my depreciation videos on the depreciation playlist. And if you'd like a copy of my cheat sheet, then it's right here. Till next time.